Good afternoon. This is John Todd. I wanted to talk to you just a little bit today about your elder care journey and where are you? My name is John Todd. I worked for the long-term medical Medicaid office for 5 years. That would be financial eligibility for nursing home, assisted living, and in-home care. I got a bit tired of being told, don't coach the customers. You can't tell them the secret rules. They have to use magic words before they can get that benefit. I got tired of that, and so I quit my job with the Medicaid office, and I've been helping families preserve assets legally and ethically for the community spouse and the families that do not need the Medicaid. And we do that by following the Medicaid rules. Anyway, today I just wanted to look at this idea of elder care journey. Where are you? Now, we're all in a life and death situation, and as far as I can tell, there's only three options. We're either going to die young suddenly, or we're going to live long and die old fairly suddenly, or we're going to have health problems along the way. Now, as far as I know, all of us are going to fit into one of those three categories. So, how do we plan for that? I wanted to look here that at the age 65, 7 in 10 will need long-term care. That's due to advances in medicine, longer life expectancies. You know, and I know many people that if they were to retire at age 65, they could enjoy many decades of their life before they finally pass away. Eventually, we begin to have mobility or memory problems or some other kind of chronic illness where you're probably not going to get better. That could include Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, any other of those long-term diseases. So again, we're in this journey. Are we going to die young? Are we going to die old all of a sudden? Or are we going to fall into one of these chronic illnesses and probably not going to get better and just kind of continue for some time? All of us are going to fit into one of those categories. Well, planning. How do you plan for those three options? What works for you? Where are you in that journey? Of course, the easiest and the most options are when you do some pre-planning. Some of the basics you already know. You ought to have a power of attorney, both financial and medical. Have those done, completed. Make sure that the person that's going to be your power of attorney knows and they have a copy or know how to find a copy of that document. Do you have a will, and is it an up-to-date will, and does it plan for the contingencies? A lot of the old kinds of wills are stale, and they don't, people didn't live long after 65 or into retirement, and so they just said, well, this will happen if I die, but there's not much contingency upon what's going to happen if I live long? So you might review your will. And then, of course, there's life insurance and long-term care coverage insurance. Those are options if you're going to do some pre-planning. I did want to look though at another option here. What are you going to do if you need crisis planning? So that's really the two categories of planning is pre-planning or crisis planning, and which one's going to work for you? Crisis planning is what we say when we get into that situation. Well, I need help now. I need care now. I'm already in the nursing home, or my mom's already in the nursing home. My mom's already in the assisted living. My dad already needs in-home care. And then what do we do? Of course, you have less options there, but a lot of us are in that situation where our loved one needs help and we're in this crisis planning. I just wanted to let you know that there are options, even if you have assets or income, and you're in the crisis planning situation. I can help with both kinds of planning, pre-planning and crisis planning, but crisis planning options need the advice of a knowledgeable professional. I just want to throw that out there. So here I am again. That's my picture. Long-term care. I've been working in Medicaid. I've helped people with especially the crisis planning. Hundreds of families I've helped them qualify if that's what they needed. If you have questions about long-term Medicaid and crisis planning, they're already in the facility and wanting to try to save some money. Contact me if you'd like. eldercarefinancialllc@gmail.com. Again, eldercarefinancialllc@gmail.com. Notice financial ends in the letter L, and then I added LLC at the end. So that makes it look like three L's in a row. Don't forget that you need all three of them there in order to get to me. Feel free to contact me if you have questions. Stay tuned and I'll be glad to give you another update on one of these more about Medicaid and financial planning, crisis planning if needed, or pre-planning. Thanks. Have a good day.